Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I want to talk about corporate finance mind mapping by me, James Eugene Atmaja, from MBA September 2021, IPMI International Business School, and our lecturer is Prof. Roy Semble, Distinguished Chair for Finance and Investment and faculty member at IPMI International Business School. So I divided the mind mapping into 6 parts. We are in part 1. Part 1 is talking about financial management, good governance, cornerstones of corporate finance, assignments and examination review, and time value of money. So let's get into the part 1. Number 1 is financial management. We are talking about optimal orchestration of internal and external financial resources towards significant and sustainable value creation. So number 2, we are talking about good governance. Good governance is talking about transparency, accountability, responsibility, independency, and fairness, or could be summarized as tarif. Number 3 is cornerstones of corporate finance. It consists of core of value principle, conservation of value principle, expectation treadmill principle, and best owner principle. Number 4, we are talking about time value of money. There is a rule of 72. There is a rule that can measure how long does it takes to double up your investment. And there's the equation. And number 5 is assignments or examination review. There's individual assignments, groups assignments, and final examination. So let's get into the part 2 of the mind mapping, which is talking about investment fraud and capital budgeting. In investment fraud, we should do our own research for the company, the owner of the company, the contract, the legality, the product, the transaction mechanism, and the logic. Is it too good to be true or not? And number 2, we are talking about capital budgeting. Capital budgeting is talking about long-term investment, accept or reject project based on 4 measurements. Number 1 is payback period. Number 2 is net present value or NPV. Number 3 is PI. And number 4 is ERR. So in part 3 of the mind mapping, we are talking about number 1, fundamental analysis. Number 2 is technical analysis. And number 3 is financial statement analysis. So in fundamental analysis, we are talking about domestic and global economic analysis, industry analysis, company analysis, intrinsic value, and fundamental indicators. Number 2, we are talking about technical analysis that consists of momentum phase reversal, trend, up and down, support and resistance, gap, triangle, double bottom and top, and moving average. And number 3 is financial statement analysis. We're talking about profitability, liquidity, activity, leverage, market ratio, natural level, quality of numbers, historical trend, industry benchmark, and decomposition using DuPont analysis. So let's move on into part 4 of the mind mapping, which is talking about portfolio theory and capital structure. In portfolio theory, we are talking about potential, actual, and required return, ex ante and ex post measurement, return phase risk, total, systematic, and unsystematic risk, correlation and diversification, efficient frontier portfolio, CAPM, and the equation of CAPM. Number 2 is capital structure. We are talking about long-term sources of fund, debt and preferred, shareholders' equity, Modigliani and Miller theory, integration of tax effects, financial distress cost, and factors of capital structure. So let's get into the part 5 of the mind mapping. We are talking about corporate restructuring. In corporate restructuring, talking about number 1 is financial distress that consists of a flow. Number 1 is early impairment, deterioration of performance, cash flow problem, failure, default, insolvency, and bankruptcy. Number 2, we are talking about surviving and transforming businesses, consists of stop the bleeding, financial restructuring, temporary pivoting, strategic realigning, redefining core business, and new ways of doing business. And number 3, we are talking about restructuring, how. Number 1 is capital structure, working capital management, asset structure, revenue management, cost management, risk, growth, and cash flow management. And we too talking about RJR Nabisco Leverage Buyout or LBO case study. So we are in the last part of the mind mapping. The last part of the mind mapping, we are talking about fraud risk management and dividend policy. Fraud risk management is talking about corruption that consists of conflict of interest, bribery, illegal gratuities, economic extortion. Number two, we are talking about asset misappropriation, consists of cash and inventory and all asset. Number three, we are talking about fraudulent statements, that is financial and non-financial. We too talking about fraud triangle, that is perceived pressure, perceived opportunity, and rationalization. Next, we are talking about fraud reasons. There are some reasons such as huge personal debt or losses, lifestyle beyond income, and overspeculation, and many others. Next, we are talking about fraud prevention, that is using whistleblower, SOPs, and employee ethics. And we are talking too about incentives. There is consists of four part. Number one is moral, social, monetary, and physical. In dividend policy, we are talking about dividend debate with our professor. So that's all from the mind mapping. The lesson that I learned in the class that is really interesting and memorable, that it's okay to make mistake. You will learn from your mistakes, by Prof. Roy Sembel. Thank you all for watching and listening to my video presentation. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment down below. Thank you all, and see you guys in the next video.